Hi, this is a water purifier DC pump motor, and the good news is that it is damaged. So in this video, I'm going to open it up, rectify the problem and see if it works. And one important thing, if you look at the back of it, you can see that the screw heads have been cut off, which means that the repair person tried to open it up, but he could not. So it is going to be a little tricky this time. So as you saw that I successfully managed to open one of the screws by reconstruction of its head, while for the other one, the left out layer was very thin because of which it chopped off automatically during screw making process. So you see there is no brush left for one of the terminals, the positive one, and this one is almost at its end, and that's the reason why the motor was not running. Let's see if we can find something else. So much carbon powder. The left out brush. So this was a screw that was not opening and broke off. Finally, the main armature. It's quite big and seems powerful, although there is one thing to notice. The commutators have been used a lot. You can see the curve available on the commutator bars. So starting with the field cleaning. The magnets are quite big and strong, which indicates the strength of the motor. Moving on to the armature cleaning, seems like all the carbon particles have accumulated on the top of the motor. Somehow it's filled with carbon particles. Nice. Moving on to the brush housing part. So the number of turns that have been given to the armature slots is very high, and the winding that has been used is very thin, which means that if this motor is going to be used as a generator, it is going to produce high voltage and low current, and rest we can see later in this video. Now for the alignment check, here you can see the hole is matching. As for this one, same here. So finally, the motor seems to be repaired, and now it is time to test it. Now, this is a 24 volts DC motor. So here I'm going to use this variable DC power supply that also has a maximum output voltage of 24 volts DC. And as you can see, it is running fine. Although the RPM is quite low because the motive behind this motor is to run it at low RPM and at higher torque. Plus, it has to run continuously for pumping water. So many of you might have already seen this 4 kilowatts motor speed controller that I made in one of my previous videos, link for which will be provided in the description, and I've connected this controller to the motor through this pin. Now let's hold it strongly before turning it on. The switch is on. Now slowly turning the knob. And yeah, it is running. That is so cool, man. This controller is so nice that it can even control a 24 volts motor. Now let's increase the RPM. This one is very powerful, 4 kilowatts, and the motor is really small comparatively. Okay. Oh. Nice. That is so cool, man. That was a very good test, and it was successful. This controller can actually control motors from 24 volts to 200 volts. So here I've connected my multimeter in the voltage measurement mode to my DC motor, which I'm going to use as a generator now. As you can see that it is producing around 5 volts, 8 volts with hand rotation. Let's see the maximum I can do. 9, 11 volts, 11.42, 12.13 volts. So 12 volts was the maximum I could produce with hand rotation. Now I'm going to connect my cordless drill. Yeah, it's been connected. And go. Oh, the voltage was too high, 200 volts mode, and again. So 31 volts was the maximum voltage that could be produced. Now let's try the same thing with a bigger drill machine. Turn on the switch. And easily producing 25 volts. Let's go higher. And here we have crossed the initial generated voltage. Moving on to the full power. Now, for load testing with this 12 volts, 55 watts bulb, I will be using this DC to DC buck converter with 36 to 48 volts DC input and 12 volts, 25 amperes DC output. So here I've connected the converter and the bulb. It is time to begin the show. And nice. Let's turn off the lights. Again. One more light left out.